There's always that question when fall comes crashing through the window. When's the Christmas music gonna start playing? Admittedly, I'm a big sucker for Christmas in the wintertime. The cozy feeling of looking outside and seeing little puffballs cascade through the wind, hearing the crackle of the fireplace, and feeling the glow of the Christmas tree all while Santa is stuck in the chimney is a feeling that I will never take for granted. Someone give me some hot chocolate right now, it's getting me too excited. I'm obviously not the only one that thinks this. Besides the fact that there are 2.4 billion Christians and at least 3 of them have to feel the same way as I do, amen. Christmas and winter are the backdrop for hundreds of pieces of media. Christmas is basically its own genre at the Hallmark channel. They're blasting out movies like t-shirts at a Pistons game. With all the Christmas love, one must ask, what about fall? You know, the time between summer and winter, where it seems like the entire world has a beautiful orange hue. When the children run back to school, and we all collectively grab our warmest hoodies. When raw denim and boots are the sign of the changing weather, not a confusing sense of style. Fall is undoubtedly one of the most underrated seasons, which is shown in the lack of fall media. Don't get me wrong, there's the occasional fall movie or phone book or calendar or whatever, but compared to winter or even summer, it is very easy to see that fall is incredibly underrepresented. That's why I would like to take a moment to describe the beauty of fall in media, and better yet, explain the metaphorical purpose of the season. While winter represents a feeling of family and warmth, fall gives off a feeling of change, maturity, and the passing of time. The beautiful switch from green leaves to orange that makes you want to eat a pumpkin bowl tells of a time where things aren't quite the same anymore. This is a powerful metaphor seen in the very few fall movies, but we'll get to those in a bit. For now, let's describe the different types of fall media. So to determine what a true fall movie is, it would be helpful to look at its competition. In this corner, we have 7-3, 350 pounds of pure Christmas, fit with all things jolly, including but not limited to
snow, hot cocoa, snowmen, friends and family, big dinners, turkey, Santa, elves, a feeling of warmth, fireplaces, and infinitely baking treats.
Usually the problem centers around the balance between work and love or accepting family as a core piece of your lifestyle. This category of fall, aptly named Christmas-type movies except for fall, focuses solely on the season. Movies like It's the Great Pumpkin, Charlie Brown, Halloween Town, or Twitches come to mind. While we're here, let's take a look at this beautiful opening scene from that Charlie Brown flick. Waves of leaves on the ground, with a beautiful orange hue and a red sky filled with pumpkins and costumes, is everything fall-related, making this a beautiful opening to a purely fall movie. These are celebrations of the season. Fall in its purest form. Rather than fall being important to the narrative, as we'll see in other movies, fall is the narrative. Charlie is invited to a Halloween party, and Linus hopes to be visited by the Great Pumpkin, which I'm assuming is some twisted version of a Wendigo. Usually these movies aren't too serious and mostly focus towards children, but like Home Alone, they're the perfect background noise for any ages, especially when carving pumpkins. Next on our list is the visual form of fall media. This category doesn't really use fall for any specific purpose except to be gawked at. Levels in a video game that revolve around fall or use it as a theme are staples of this category, with the best in my opinion being Gold Leaf Galaxy from Super Mario Galaxy. Even though this planet is basically a rehash of the all-time great Honey Hive Galaxy, there are parts of this level that make it distinctly fall. The orange and brown color palette, the leaf textures on the floor, that beautiful wood, it all screamed pumpkins and spooky scary skeletons. However, this easily could have been improved. There could have been some enemies and fall costumes, for example. It could have just been more fall than it really is right now, as Nintendo have done this stuff in the past. That's why this is more of a firm nod to the season, rather than something I want to experience every single time the leaves start falling. Again, there's not too much to these, but they stand out in the avalanche of Christmas content. This movie is somewhat of an overlap between the metaphorical section and the visual section, but I just want to take a second and show you guys how beautiful this film is because of the season. This movie just oozes all out of its gross teenage pores. It takes place during the season, and pair this with the bright colors in the 1950s Connecticut setting, and every frame has a beautiful expression of fall. There are also vast wide shots showing the beautiful vegetation of the season, with trees as tall as skyscrapers and plastered with little paints of orange and yellows and reds. Someone get me my favorite hoodie right now. Clearly, fall can make any film more visually interesting, but when utilized correctly, it can have a metaphorical purpose too, which leads us to our next section. Fall serves a purpose narratively, metaphorically, and visually. These pieces of media simply cannot exist without the season. My favorite media. For all three of you that didn't have to read this absolute gem of a book as part of your junior English class, let's get a quick rundown. Spotlight on Nick Carraway, who moves to New York in the year 1922, the Roaring Twenties. He moves next to Gatsby, a millionaire who got his wealth through shady means, drugs and whatnot. He lives across the pond from his ex-lover Daisy and her terrible husband Tom. As the story progresses, Gatsby and Daisy's love rekindles, and tensions rise between the disgustingly rich families, eventually leading to Gatsby's death in his own pool. What makes this a fall book is the fact that the movie begins in the fall and transitions to summer over time. The transition from cozy nights to deathly hot dinner parties represents the rise in tension between the families, and the rebirth of a ferocious love. Essentially, in this book, fall is synonymous with change, rise in tension, and the rekindling of a lost love, which F. Scott Fitzgerald perfectly encapsulates in his quote, "Life starts all over again when it gets crisp in the fall." Just beautiful. God, someone give me some hot cider. Can someone give me some hot cider, please? This cult classic starring Fall Williams follows a group of lads as they start a new school season at a ridiculously pretentious high school. Seriously, this place is akin to Hogwarts with those statues that kind of just stare at you all the time. I personally love this movie. The message that art and self-worth shouldn't be sacrificed for some meaningless grade is a beautiful critique on the school system and was infinitely entertaining. With a movie about starting school, fall is bound to make an appearance, but its use in this film is just breathtaking. It is used on a narrative, visual, and metaphorical level. They really went all out with this one. First, obviously, fall needs to be in the plot. The school season is starting, which means that it's just fall. The beginning of the school year, and therefore fall, is symbolic of a big change that's about to come. As the school year progresses and the seasons change, so do the characters. They become more receptive of Mr. Williams' ideas, and they eventually become more akin to the idea of poetry and art. Blah blah blah. Who cares? Give me the fall. Although the film eventually transitions out of fall, giving the season heavy screen time and giving it lots of symbolic meaning shows that it has a sense of change. The movie also uses the season in a stunning way visually. Sweaters, vests, and sweater vests are all seen in the uniforms of the students. But the sweeping landscape shots of the mist floating over the lake and the beautiful hues of the early and late skies makes this movie truly feel like fall. These shots are more than a visual backdrop, however, as they show the cold and condescending nature of the school when the boys are separate and the beautiful connection they have when they're together. Through the metaphorical usage, the visual usage, and the narrative prominence, there is no doubt that this is an extremely fall movie. As we can see in this fun little film, fall movies can span a multitude of genres. However, Halloween is significant in this fall movie title because it differentiates itself from other horror movies. See, Halloween is a fall movie because 1. It heavily relies on fall for the narrative, 2. It uses fall in lots of visual ways, and 3. It simply takes place during the fall. This is the difference between, let's say, Halloween and The Invisible Man. The story only works because it's fall. And because it's Halloween in the 70s, a time where child safety and stalkerish tendencies were taken pretty lightly, no one questions Michael Strain's demeanor and his mask. Furthermore, the Halloween and fall aesthetic adds to the eerie atmosphere of the film, meaning it relies on the season both narratively and visually. The Invisible Man, however, does none of this. It's just a pretty good horror movie. I'm making this comparison because people seem to get the wrong idea when associating horror movies with fall movies. Just because something's scary doesn't automatically make it a fall movie because Halloween is in fall. Essentially, Halloween is an outlier of these horror movies. It's a fall movie and a horror movie. Not just a scary movie that, oh my god, we have to watch for our Halloween marathon. Oh my god, it's gonna be so scary. Someone turn out the lights. Come on, turn out the lights. Many people point to this movie as giving off fall vibes. I have to agree. The movie gives off an incredible sense of autumn in too many ways that I can count. I mean, look at his little suit. But I wouldn't say this just gives off fall vibes. This is a definitively fall movie. See, fall vibes are a title given to movies that aren't fall movies, but just have that type of autumn atmosphere. But we'll talk about that later. This movie is distinct from fall because of the season's visual significance and how fluidly it blends into the narrative. The film's color palette revolves all around beautiful fall colors. The animals are moving into a new house because of hibernation, and the main antagonist makes apple cider for a living. Come on, that's like the most fall thing there is. Everything about this movie screams fall. Even those delicious cookies with the thin little apple slices on top. The theme has an upbeat quality to it, with tight string instruments with little plucks giving off the feeling of a cool autumn breeze. The cozy feeling I get from this movie as a result of the fall aspects makes this a must watch every time the leaves fall. Definitively autumn. But Before, we looked at this movie's visuals pretty surface level. We discussed how when using the foliage and colors of autumn, it can give a very unique visual aesthetic to your movie. However, these visuals are like 4th of July fireworks, as they serve a purpose. If you haven't seen this movie, one, get on that, what's wrong with you? And two, it's about the sexist and racist tendencies underlying the beautiful suburban life of the 1950s. All the main characters have cool autumn outfits, a very nice house, and overall, a desirable lifestyle. However, they're all corrupt in some way, which shows itself when the new gardener of the main character is a black man. The amazing autumn colors works to create a sense of innocence and beauty with the suburban life that heavily contrasts the horrific underbelly of this beast. Essentially, the colors of autumn evoke a certain emotion that works to the narrative themes, meaning that fall visuals don't have to be just something pretty. These are pieces of media that give off fall vibes. I'm all for a good fall movie, book, game, whatever. But just because something gives off fall vibes doesn't make it a fall piece of media. Let's take a look at some examples, see what separates these bozos from the big dogs. This film is deceptively a fall movie. What I mean by this is that the film starts off with some amazing fall elements. Autumn parades, apple bobbing contests, and the like. Obviously, I was excited during this part, so you can imagine my disappointment not even halfway through the movie, the film flips to a distinctly Christmas movie, and eventually to summer, without acknowledging those beautiful orange trees of the past. Now, how is this different than Dead Poets Society? Both of these take place in the fall, and have a sense of change. But the difference is, in You've Got Mail, there isn't much prominence of the season to make it useful narratively or metaphorically. The movie really could have begun and ended in any season and would have had the same effect, meaning it doesn't really make it a distinctly fall movie. Meaning, it's simply a movie that gives off fall vibes. But who knows, maybe I'll let this one slide if someone can convince me. While doing research for this video, research for a fall movie video, I stumbled across a couple of articles that ranked the best fall movies over My Dead Body. That's my job. Most of these movies are, quite frankly, not fall movies. They just give off fall vibes. Sometimes in incredibly minuscule ways that is disgusting to even call them fall movies. But essentially, I could break down every movie on these lists and explain how they're not fall movies. But one of the worst lists I saw was one that said A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood is one of the best fall movies. Don't get me wrong, it's a fine movie. Tom Hanks plays America's sweetheart in Mr. Rogers, and the most wholesome role I've ever seen. But is it a fall movie? Well, let's check, because the list gives reasons as to why these are fall movies, so it should probably clear up my confusion, right? Okay, this is good. This is a good joke. The reason this movie is fally, as it says in the article, is because nobody can rock a red sweater like Mr. Rogers.
It's pretty difficult to put into words how disgusted I am, how depressed I am.
What? I mean, I agree. Nobody can rock a sweater like my guy over here. But that does not make this a fall movie. The season is not used in any important way, visually, metaphorically, or narratively. It really holds no purpose in the story. So why is it a fall movie? I can wear a sweater anytime. Sure, it would probably be hot and itchy in the summer, but I could still do it. This specific piece of wardrobe gives off fall vibes, sure, I love a sweater in fall, but that does not make this a fall movie. What I'm trying to get across in this video is that there are so many ways to use seasons in your stories. Christmas and winter have been done about a million times in so many different movies, and it's successful. That's probably why there's going to be about a million more in, I don't know, next 2 weeks. Fall is just such a beautiful and cozy season that I think it deserves its own pieces of media that we can get excited for whenever the leaves start falling again. Fall can serve a purpose in your story, and if done very well, can make people excited for decades to come every time the season rolls around. So how about it? Let's get some fall media that we can enjoy every single autumn, because this season is just too beautiful to pass up. Now, I'm gonna go get some warm apple cider. Thanks for watching.